reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God remains in him and he in God. We have to come to know, to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Whoever believes in me, even passages, one of my favorite characters in all of the New Testament, the very gift of St. Martha. And of course, you can't have Martha without Mary, the two sisters together. But often teased that Monsignor Russell and myself, may he rest in peace, were like Martha and Mary. He was the one who would sit for hours before the Blessed Sacrament and do his prayers. And I was the one who wanted to keep on going and keep on moving. Just say, slow down. And perhaps that's the challenge of the gospel this day. The challenge of the Feast of St. Martha. That we search for so many things within our lives. And look over the past couple of weeks, how absolutely thrilled we were when the salons and the beauty parlors opened up. The restaurants began to open up. The gyms. And you could then go and get whatever you needed at the grocery stores. All answers to a deeper challenge. And the solution to that deeper challenge is exactly in the gift of Martha, who left and went out to seek the Lord, went out to find him, to be with him. And in her tremendous acclamation of faith, I know whatever you ask will be given to you. Your brother will rise. It's unfortunate that we are surrounded by so much illness, so much death. But yet each and every one of those moments, sacred in the gift of life, calls all of us to an appreciation of the very gift of life and a realization